गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे वी शैल बी गोइंग टू स्टडी आवर 1.1 लेसन एन एस्ट्रोलॉजर्स डे पार्ट टू। इन द पार्ट टू, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी सम अप आवर फर्स्ट पार्ट। इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ आवर लेसन वी हैव सीन दैट the vendor of fried groundnuts gave his very fancy name like Bombay ice cream, Delhi almond, Raja's delicacy and so on, and people were amused. A large number of people were attracted, just like a honeybee. How honeybee flocked towards the flowers, and later on how honeybee sucked the nectar from the flowers and makes the honeycomb. Okay, similarly the people they were gathered there and they were attracted towards that astrologer. As the astrologer was seated right next to him, the groundnut vendor's customer dallied near astrologer and were probably tempting to consult him. So large number of clients they were gathering there and they were consulting to the astrologers, and in this way the astrologers he tried to sort out the routine problems of the people in a large number, and from morning to evening he was doing his business activities, and whatever money he is earning on that money he is earning his bread and butter. So this is the short glance of the first passage. In the second passage, what we saw, the exceptional qualities of the place where lack of municipal lighting, where the astrologer, where he was conducting his business transaction, there was no municipal lighting, and he used to conduct his business activity with the light of fires from the groundnut vendors. Okay, he take the help of hissing glass light with neck flares, and some on cycle lamp, some vendors they were with the help of kerosene lamp they were running their business, and he's taking the help and support of other shopkeepers. He does not have his own lamp, he does not have his own power, and in this way bewildering his course of light rays and moving shadows. So then in the third passage, what we had discussed, he was very much shrewd, shrewd means clever. Astrologer is very much clever at his guesswork. He studied the human nature and practiced reading people's mind, okay, and the daily problems of routine problems of the people, and he is having analysis of human trouble, perceptions of the woes of his customer. He is having a suitable statement that flatter the customer. He is mastered at giving the flattery to his customer. He is manipulating, he is diverting to his customer, and in this way he was earning the money by asking some general question which is similar in everybody's life. Ambiguous and general question which could be common to anybody. So all these things we have discussed in our part first. Okay, now let us have a glance over the passage number fourth, second part of our lesson. In the passage number fourth, the astrologer we come across towards the astrologers, he wind up his business activities. Means it was the time of evening, and all the vegetable vendors, groundnuts vendors, and all these traders, they were going to towards their home. They were winding up. They were closing their shops. So what happened at that time? That man, Guru Nayak, to whom he had stepped when he was very young, at young age. So he came and he started asking him the question. So the reaction of the astrologers to the man Guru Nayak are, he felt challenged, annoyed, uncomfortable. He shivered the man's grip. Means what? The reaction was that astrologer, when he came, he says that, please you give me some satisfactory reply to my reply to me. Okay, I am giving you a challenge. And the astrologer, he was having a very good image in the market. So the people, they revered him, they respect him in the market. So that Guru Nayak, that man, he behaved in a very rude manner, and that's why the astrologer, he felt annoyed. Okay, he felt annoyed, he became angry, he felt uncomfortable, and then he started shivering, means trembling. The man's grip means what? He recognized, he identified that man to whom he has killed at his young age is alive, and due to this he ran away from village to the city. Okay, so after misidentifying that man is alive, so at that time he started shivering, trembling. Who? That astrologer. Then his voice shook and became faint. His throat dried up. His voice shook and he became faint. Okay, he felt exhausted. His throat dried up, and the astrologer was annoyed also because on that man. He cut short his word rudely and told him to tell him something worthwhile. What he says means Guru Nayak, he was not listening the complete statement, sentence of the astrologer, and in between he was interrupting the astrologer, and in this way the astrologer, he was annoyed, he became very much angry on Guru Nayak. Then what happened? The next point is that the astrologer was used to people listening eagerly, respectfully to him. So the astrologer, he felt challenged, and in this way he started tilting the his palms, and that green shaft of light means car was crossing on the road, and with the help of the deeper light he was taking some help and support, and it was too much late at midnight he encountered with Guru Nayak. Then he says, "Oh, stop that," the other said. Tell me something worthwhile. Our friend felt piqued. Means astrologer, he was very much annoyed. Piqued means become very much annoyed. Piqued means annoyed. Become angry. So the astrologers, he felt very much angry. Why? Because a large number of people, they behave him in a very revered manner, respectful manner, and the Guru Nayak, he came and he says that I am giving you challenge, you have to accept whatever I am saying, and you have to give me a satisfactory reply. You are telling yourself an astrologer, I am challenging you, you are astrologer, okay, I am asking you some question. If you are giving me the correct response, then I will consider you an astrologer and I will give you money. Okay, then bargaining takes place. He says that I will give you 8 annas. Then he says that if I will give complete answer to you, then you give me 1 rupee. Sometime he says that I am charging 3 pais, but I will charge 1 rupee. So like that way, because it is the night time and he was about to wind up his business and he was going home, and at that time he came and he behaved in a rude manner. That's why the astrologers, he felt very much annoyed on that man Guru Nayak, and Guru Nayak that astrologers, he identified him, the man to whom I have stepped, that is a Guru Nayak, because he knew each and everything about him. Then he gave correct answer, whatever he has replied, whatever question he has asked, he has given a correct response. Then next point is the behavior of a man Guru Nayak showed that he did not value the usual smooth talk. That's why the astrologer felt piqued. Piqued means annoyed. Now next. All right, provided you give me twice as much. If you are wrong, said the astrologers. This pact was accepted. Pact means agreement. Here pact means agreement. Pact means agreement. Agreement, meaning is agreement. Okay, pact. Then astrologer set up a prayer to heaven as the other lit a cheroot. Cheroot is a cigarette, one kind of cigarette. Cigar means cigarette. The astrologer caught a glimpse of his face by the match light. So that was too much darkness. So what he did, astrologers, he burned one match stick towards his face, and then what happened? He read some magical words we can say the mantra, mantar, 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 that mantar. He started and he started looking at the heaven, means prayer to a heaven, as the other lit a cheroot, is a cigar. After taking the cigarette, deep smoke of the cigarette, he caught a glimpse of his fancy face by the light, mesh light. There was a pause as cars hooted on the road, jutka divers swore at their horses, and the babble of the crowd agitated the semi-darkness of the park. Here, hooted. Hooted means what? Hooted means to make a loud, clamorous, mechanical sound. Make a loud noise. Hooted means loud noise. Let us write down the meaning first. Hooted. Hooted means loud noise. I am writing upside. Loud noise. Hooted means loud noise. Then jutka divers, jutka diver, jutka means jutka diver, horse driven cart, horse driven cart, jutka, jutka means horse driven cart, jutka, jutka means horse driven, horse driven, horse driven car, horse driven. Car, horse driving car. Jutka means horse driving car. Swore at their horses, and the babble of the crowd agitated. Babble of the crowd means to talk enthusiastically. Babble means to talk enthusiastically. Babble. Babble means to talk enthusiastically. Meaning babble. Talk enthusiastically. Talk enthusiastically. Enthusiastically. So I am writing downside. Enthusiastically. Talk enthusiastically. Talk enthusiastically. Babble. The crowd agitated the semi-darkness of the park. The other sat down, sucking his cheroot, puffing out, sat there ruthlessly. Means what? The astrologer, he sat there, he took a very deep breath by taking the smoking the cigarette, and their jutka divers, means horse driven carts, they were going to their home, and in this way, whatever cars were coming on the way, with the help of, with the shaft, means shadow of the light of the car, deeper, he was looking the object, and with the help of match light, he identified the face of Guru Nayak, and later on he started taking his question as a challenge. Okay, who this Guru Nayak? He considered him as a challenge. Challenge what? Challenge to give the correct response to the man Guru Nayak. Then next, the astrologer felt very uncomfortable. Here, take your Anna back. That a man, he gave some Anna. During the olden time, there was Anna. Rupee came, too late. Earlier, at the time of our forefathers, there were Annas. One Anna, two Anna, one Pi. Then Pi is the smallest unit. Okay, then it became Anna. Then after Annas, it came Rupee. The astrologer felt very uncomfortable. Hey, take your Anna back. He says, take your Anna back. I must not use to such challenge. He said that I am not accepting your challenge. You take Anna. It is too late for me. Today I am going. So you come tomorrow. Today I am not going to give you any kind of response. So it is too late for me. You come tomorrow. The astrologer said to that Guru Nayak. He made preparation to bundle up. He was winding up his business. All the equipments he has put into the box. Cowrie shell, notebook, palmera, etc. The other held his wrist and said, you can't get out of it now. You dragged me in while I was passing. The astrologer shivered in his grip and his voice shook and became faint. So what happened? That man, he says that he dragged him. He caught his hand, he dragged him, and he says that I will not allow you to go home. But unless and until you are not giving me the correct answer. Okay, I am testing your wisdom. You have to give the response anyhow. The astrologer shivered. He started trembling. and his wife shook and became faint. Leave me today, I will speak to you tomorrow. He says that you come tomorrow, it is too much, it is a night time, I am getting late, my wife is waiting for me at home, okay, let me go home. The other thrust his palm and his face and says, the challenge is challenge, go on. The astrologer proceeded with his thought, drying up, there is a woman. So what happened? The astrologers, he was shivering, he was trembling. And why he was trembling? Because he identified the man to whom he has stepped is alive. So after looking him alive, he was faint. He was he felt very much anxiety. He was having anxiety of that man to whom he has killed is alive. After looking all these things, he felt very much anxious to go home, and in this way the astrologer proceeded with his thought. His thought became dry, and there is a woman. So in the passage number 4, what we have seen, the astrologer is challenged by the Guru Nayak, and other people passers by also that were surrounded him, and he gave challenge. He says that it is too late for me, let me go home, tomorrow I will give you the answer. Then he says that if suppose you are giving me a wrong answer, if suppose not giving satisfactory answer to me, then what I will do, I will charge the ana from you with interest, okay. If you he says that if you fail to give me correct response. So that's why the astrologers, he knew each and everything in and out of Guru Nayak. So he is not willing to respond. He says that tomorrow I will give you the answer. So in this way, the bargaining takes place. In the passage number 4, he says that you give me 1 rupee. Then he says that you pay me 8 anas. In this way, bargaining takes place. Bargaining among Guru Nayak and these astrologers. So in the fourth passage, he accepted the challenge of Guru Nayak, and then what happened? He started giving him the response, whatever question he has asked. Now in the passage number 4, passage number 5. In passage number 5, what is the story, main idea? Idea is that predictions of an astrologer means whatever question he has asked, so he has given a correct answer to every question to the Guru Nayak. Okay, now let us have a glance over the passage number 5. In the passage number 5, the predictions of astrologers. He says that your name is Guru Nayak. Yes, then he says, you know my name? Then he says, you were stabbed with a knife by a young man when you were at your young age, and that man, he has threw you into the well, and some passers-by, they rescued your life. So then he says, this incident happened with me. How you come to know? He started giving all that response because he knew him very well. Simply was fooling astrologer to that man. And in this way, he started manipulating to the man Guru Nayak. Let us have a glance over the passage number 5. He stopped, said the other, I don't want all that. Shall I succeed in my present search or not? Answer this and go. Otherwise, I will not allow you till you disgorge all your coins. What is saying? Now you give me the correct answer. Unless until you are not giving me correct answer, whatever money you have earned a whole day, that I will confiscate. You have to surrender your money, coins to me. Who says? Guru Nayak to astrologer. The astrologer muttered. Muttered means to say something. Muttered a few incantation. Incantation means that prayer. Incantation is a prayer, magical prayer, incantation. Okay, incantation. Let me point out this first. Incantation, magical prayers, magical prayers. Magical prayers. We can say that mantra, they are reciting the mantra, na, astrologer. Magical prayer. Magical prayer. Incantation. All right, I will speak, but will you give me a rupee if what I say is convincing? He says that if I say whatever, if I will give you convincing answer, then you will give me a rupee, one rupee. Who says that astrologer to Guru Nayak? Then what happened? All right. Then otherwise I will open, not open my mouth, and you may do what you like. After a good deal of haggling. Haggling means bargaining. Haggling. Haggling means bargaining. Haggling means haggling. Where is haggling? Haggling means bargaining. Where it gone? Bargaining. B-A-R-G-A-I-N-I-N-G. Bargaining. So what he says? If otherwise I will not open my mouth, whatever you want to do, you do it. Haggling. H-A-G-G-L-I-N-G. Haggling means bargaining. 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 In market, when we are going to purchase some articles, some goods, how we are doing bargaining? Similarly here, bargaining takes place among the Guru Nayak and the astrologer. The other agreed. The astrologer said, you were left for dead. Am I right? He says that you were left for dead. One man, he stabbed the knife in your stomach and he threw you into the well and he ran away. Am I right? Who says? Astrologers to the Guru Nayak. Then what he's saying? I see once again great danger to your life. If you go home, go from home. He took out a pinch, sacred ash, and held it to him. Rub it to your forehead and go home. Never travel southward again, and you will live to be 100. What he says? Even now I am seeing some dangers in your life. If you will never travel southward, your house is long away. It is to a 2 days journey from this city. If suppose you are traveling towards southward, then I see some danger. Some dangers are there. Some dangers are there. So you may suffer. So I suggest you not to travel toward southward. So in this way, astrologers started giving some suggestion. So now haggling means bargaining. Haggling, once again I am marking it. Earlier the screen was not clear. Haggling means bargaining. Upside I am writing. Haggling means bargaining. Bargaining. Then our next screen is I once see again great danger to your life. Then he says that don't travel towards southward. Then why should I leave home again? The other said effectively, I was only going away now and then to look for him and to choke out his life. If I met him, he shook his head regretfully. He has escaped my hand. I hope at least he died as he deserved. Here, said the astrologer, he crushed under a lorry. The other looked gratified to him. So what happened? He says Guru Nayak, he says that man is alive who have stabbed the knife into my stomach. He says that no, that man is dead. 4 months back, he was crushed under the lorry. Lorry is a truck. Okay, he came under the truck and he met a tragic end. His life is end. Now he is no more. He is dead. So at that time, gratified means pleased. Gratified means become pleased. Pleased means become happy. So after hearing this, that man, he was pleased. Who? Guru Nayak. He became very happy. And he said that, yes, that man, he must deserve that type of punishment. Tit for tat, whatever he has done to me, so he has met to his own destiny. So in this way, the man, he became very much happy after hearing this prediction from the astrologers. Now next slide, passage number 6. In passage number 6, this is the means climax of the story. In the passage number 6, the writer he has reached towards the climax of the story, and there the that man Guru Nayak, he was satisfied and he gave 75 paise, means 12 paise, 12 paise means 75 paise. Okay, so the place was deserted by the time the astrologer picked up his articles and put them into his bag. The green shaft was also gone, leaving the place in darkness and silence. The stranger had gone off into the light, giving the astrologer a handful of coins. So there was darkness and all the shop has closed. Now it is a midnight time and all the shop has closed, and the people they were back to their house, and there was green shaft. There green shaft means in the darkness there was silence in the marketplace, town hall. Whatever cars was going, so only shadows, reflections of the shadows of the deeper of the car was visible, and there was total darkness. The stranger had gone off into the night, giving the astrologer a handful of coins. Then, after getting satisfactory response from the questions of the Guru Nayak, that astrologers he took 12 anas, half anas, 2.5 anas. Okay. The astrologer had gone. It was nearly midnight when the astrologer reached home. His wife was waiting for him at the door and demanded an explanation. Wife, she started asking the question, why you are late? You are coming late to the house. What is the problem? So then he started giving explanation. One customer came from the village whose name was Guru Nayak, to whom I stabbed the knife when I was young. And I ran away from the village to the city. Due to this, my load was very heavy. I was having enormous tension. Okay, that police might caught me and they will put me into the prison. Like that, he started narrating the entire episode. So that man, the man to whom I have killed, he is alive. So this surprise, he started narrating to his wife. He flung the coins at her and said, count them, one man gave all that. He started flunging, okay. He flung that anna and he handed over to his wife. And he says that one man he came and he gave. You count it. Then next slide. 2.5 annas. She said counting, she was overjoyed. Means that after counting, his wife, she became very much happy. She was overjoyed. And she said that I can buy some jaggery and coconut tomorrow. The child has been asking for sweets for so many days now. So wife, she said that she became very much happy. She said that I will buy the jaggery, one kind of sweet, and coconut she will purchase tomorrow. And her daughter, she was asking for so many days to make mummy some sweet. So the child has been asking for sweet. I will prepare some nice stuff for her. The swine had cheated me. The swine has cheated me. Swine means, you know already, swine is a pig. He says that the swine has cheated me. He promised me a rupee, said the astrologer. She looked up at him. You look worried. What is wrong? Then what happened? He says that swine, he's abusing. He's giving bad word. He's saying swine to that Guru Nayak. He say because that Guru Nayak, he promised to give him 1 rupee, and he gave 12.5 annas, means near about 75 paise, not 1 rupee. He promised me a rupee, and said the astrologer. He looked up at him. You look worried. She said that you are looking very much worried. There is anxiety on your face, feeling exhausted. What is the problem? What is wrong with you? Then he said that nothing. Next, after dinner, sitting on the peol. Peol is a cot. After dinner, you know, in village. There is so in the peol, after the dinner, sitting on the peol, he told her, "Do you know a great load is gone from me today?" What he says? Do you know the great load? There was very big load on my head. From years I was bearing it, so now it has gone away. I thought I had the blood of a man on my hands all these years? He says that, yes, I thought that I had the blood of a man. Blood of a man means my hand was stained with the blood of that man, means Guru Nayak, all the years. That was the reason why I ran away from home, settled here and married you. He is alive. He said that is the reason why I left my village and why I settled in the city. Due to this reason, I am settled in this city and I am married you, and that man is still alive. This is the wonder. She gasped. Gasp means take a huge sigh of relief. You tried to kill him? Yes, in our village, when I was a silly youngster, he drank, gambled and quarreled badly one day. Why think of it now? Time to sleep, as he said, yawning, and stretched himself on the pall. So what happened? She said that, you tried to kill that man? He says, yes, when I was young, at that time, a silly youngster. So we drank, we took a liquor, we were gambling, we were quarreling among ourselves, and one day badly I stabbed a knife into his stomach and threw him into the well. Why think of it now? She said that now it is a time to sleep. He said, yawning, means he is too much tired, feeling exhausted. He took a big yawning and stretched himself on the pall, and in this way the astrologers, he slept at that night. He narrated the entire incident to his wife. So, dear student, so what is the message for us from this lesson? The message is that is very clear that astrology is an art. You know, astrology is an art, and it is it has nothing to do with the religion. People, what they are doing, simply they are putting that big sindoor and using turban, saffron color turban, and they were simply manipulating the innocent people who are illiterate. Astrology is an art. There are various methods of predicting the future, like palm reading, reading the pulse, reading the horoscope, etc. So these methods can be studied, or the knowledge can be inherited from one's ancestor. So these astrologers, what they are doing? They are illiterate. They are inheriting the knowledge. They are learning the practice, how to manipulate the people. So they are taking from their ancestor, and in this way they are becoming babas and all. And later on what happened? They tap the innocent people. However, the astrologer must have intuition and talent for this art. They are having intuition and talent, and on the basis of their practice, and on the basis of some similar question which is similar to in everybody's life, whatever incidents are happening, so all these things bearing in their mind, they are drawing the conclusion. So okay, like that, if you are not earning money, what is the problem? So some people have done some magic or what, okay, or like that, we are thinking it, but in reality it has nothing to do all these magic things and all. So it is all futile thing. And mostly the people who are illiterate, they are tangling into the net of the astrologers, and astrologers in this way, they are earning the money. Simply they are manipulating the people. So what is our responsibility, dear student, is that to eradicate superstition, that other ill practices from our society, the first and most important step is education. Education is the most powerful tool to eradicate all this superstition. And in this thing, who can play a very vital role? Schools and colleges must help the student to develop a scientific attitude and think logically and rationally. Schools and colleges must take this responsibility to eradicate teachers, professors, so they can teach their student to develop a scientific attitude, how it is coming with the help of education, and think logically and rationally. You have to think it logically and rationally. Secondly is that as the people in India tend to listen to their religious head, all religious heads should send out clear message to their followers about the eradication of superstition. So the second thing is that this religious head, they can also play a very important role to eradicate the all these evil activities from our society. Then next is, and lastly, the older generation should change their opinion and ideas and get rid of silly superstitious belief. So this is the need of an hour, is that we should think logically. We should try to find out the reason behind any happening. So all the if you will try to find out logical reasoning, scientific attitude you will develop, then definitely you will not be trapped by such type of astrologers in your life. So in the end, I would like to request you, dear student, you go through the text, read the text one, twice, thrice, and try to find out the question and answer. Suppose if you are having any doubts, then you please give me your comment on our comment box section of the YouTube channel. Second thing is that you give your comment, and your comment would be considered as your presentee. So, dear student, thank you for watching this video. Thank you very much.